the commission was Christ with a needle in his arm, and somebody, Paul Cook, is threw me in, yeah. As I had restored one about 34 years ago in Dumbarton. And I took the piece, but I said, there's no way I could put a needle in his arm, but leave it with me. And the piece kind of grew. So it's all reclaimed, it's actually scaffold boards, which is hard to get timbered during the lockdown. This is ply, reclaimed ply, and mahogany facings. It's all reclaimed. It was made mainly in the bedroom with an understanding partner. The needle, Christ crushing it, it's pointing down. It's all to do with surrender. If you surrender some like a sword, you hand the handle. So that was the thing. The mirror itself is us in Christ, or Christ in us, are a reflection of society. So people looking at it,
yes,
they can see themselves, like Christ is in us. The head comes off and goes here, and that was to signify in the back, it says, the longest journey a human being takes is from the head to the heart, which is Mother Teresa. So that's why the piece is here. The plaque itself is I lost my niece 18 years ago, Liam, a heroin overdose. So the piece is quite personal to us. Born and bred in Dumbarton, art was the only thing I was good at school. Left school, one qualification it was art, and then factories and various things. I found myself at a bad place. I lost my parents through cancer and a heart attack within 3 months each other. And unfortunately, the way I dealt with it was climbing into a ball. I found myself in recovery with Alcoholics Anonymous. And my first commission was a Statue of Christ in Dumbarton Cemetery, and it was to put a new arm on Christ. The money I got for that, I bought books, and I went through, put myself into college, became a college lecturer, and worked with behavioural kids. Kids who had the same upbringing I had. My father was quite a violent man, so I worked with kids. My medium was art, and I found that art was really good for people. I've been working various pieces. I've got a piece in Luss, so a furniture designer, a maker and designer. Pieces, Royal College of Surgeons, pieces in there. Glasgow University, where you get married, you sign the desk, it's a piece I made. Something in Luss, which is called the Cross of Light. So a lot of my pieces are quite religious, yes, or spiritual. Yes. This is one piece that's been very powerful, and I struggled with the imagery. I believe in Christ, but I couldn't put him in any bad light.
Yes.
So, as you say, the needle's pointing down the way, and it kind of made itself, the piece.
Yes. It's very powerful. It's very powerful. How do you find the reception of the art piece and sculpture in the media and in the public?
Surprisingly, the media was no bad coverage on the day of the event, but yes, other than that, there's been nothing. But there's been a lot of people, the minister of this church would take it in.
Yes.
He was quite touched with the piece. And anybody who's suffered from addiction or alcoholism or loss is actually knows without explanation what the piece means. Other people think it's a bit maybe blasphemy, but it wasn't my intentions to insult anybody or anybody's faith, and for myself I believe that it could bring people back to their faith.
Yes.
That Christ was one of us. Christ went among no the rich or the successful, but through people who suffer from addiction and through and I believe the struggle, the name of the piece would be If I Get As Bad As This, I'll Stop. Because through my addiction, I found myself in a shooting gallery, and somebody shows how to jag up, and I said, no, and I went to the toilet and I prayed, no to this. I knew I was bad in the drink. And instead of praising God, I came out and went, well, if I get as bad as that, I'll stop. But thinking an addict's somebody who puts a needle in their arm, It doesn't matter, liquid form, tablet form, yes. Powder form. And I think that was it. The minister wasn't too happy with that kind of thing. And I went, well, in the readings, Alcoholics Anonymous, is that no human power can restore replace our alcoholism, but God could and would if he were sought. And I think that's the thing. The piece itself has got a piece at the bottom that says one day at a time.
Could we see that?
Yeah. So it's made it one day at a time. Chris Christopherson and the Scottish lassie had wrote the song. And then there is a wee book for people who have sadly passed. A lot of my close friends. I just bring these in here.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. This has been our table of remembrance, remembrance for those lost to addiction in our community, those who are no longer with us. And we have been remembering them, lighting small candles in their memory. When we look at this table, we may say this is a pretty lovely table, but this is not. This is an awful table, because I believe behind each of one of these candles, there is a life of a person who is no longer with us, a person who is no longer walking our streets, visiting our places in the community, because this person has been lost to the big tragedy of addiction. And I believe this is preventable. And so we are here as a church community to offer a safe space for those who feel at the verge of breaking. Looking at the cross, I believe there is hope. There is hope because Christ died for us. And he did so to bring us hope and a new life. The message of hope we want to transmit is that as a church community, we are here and our doors are open. And if you or someone you may know is struggling without seeing a way out, please do come and talk to us, because we could be happy to help the best way we can. And we are here to bring light in the midst of darkness.